So let's start off by talking about dominant strategy, an important concept in game theory. Now, dominant strategy is defined basically as a best action that an individual can take in a situation of interdependence, in a situation where regardless of the other player, the individual acts based on his or her own best interest or the best action. Now, in order to fully understand the idea of dominant strategy, we'll be looking at two specific examples. But before that, what's important to know is that there can be either no dominant strategy or there can be a dominant strategy, and both are just as equal possibilities that can happen. So looking at this first example as to whether Dunkin' Donuts and Baskin Robbins, two of the most famous food places to go to, should set up their stores in Seoul or Bundang. And depending on where they set their market, they can basically earn different levels of profit. If both decide to set their shop in Seoul, they will each earn $500. If they both decide to go with Bundang, then they will each earn $200. And if Dunkin' Donuts selects Bundang, whereas Baskin-Robbins selects Seoul, they will each earn $700 and $100 respectively, and vice versa for the case when Dunkin' Donuts selects Seoul while Baskin-Robbins selects Bundang. Now the question here is we need to explore whether there is a dominant strategy. And the way to do this is to firstly consider what the opponent will choose. So looking at it in the perspective of our first stakeholder, Dunkin' Donuts, if Baskin-Robbins decides to produce or set its shop in Seoul, then what would be a better choice for Dunkin' Donuts? To earn $500 or $700? And the choice that's better for Dunkin' Donuts would be $700. Now, if Baskin-Robbins decides Bundang instead of Seoul, then the question for Dunkin' Donuts becomes a matter of $100 or $200. And once again, it will decide $200 over $100, which is why the dominant strategy for Dunkin' Donuts would be to produce in Bundang. However, when we look at it in the perspective of Baskin-Robbins, we need to consider how Dunkin' Donuts will act and how, respectively, Baskin-Robbins will act. So if Dunkin' Donuts decides Seoul and produces $100, then looking at it in Baskin-Robbins, $500 or $700, what would be a better option? $700. Now, if Dunkin' Donuts decide Bundang, it can earn either $700 or $200. But in the perspective of Baskin-Robbins, it can choose $100 or $200. And once again, it will select $200. Which is why in this case, the dominant strategy for both Dunkin' Donuts and Baskin-Robbins would be here, both producing at Bundang. Now let's further explore our second example here regarding prisoners. Now we have two prisoners here, prisoner A and prisoner B, and their options are to either confess or lie. If they both decide to confess, they will each have 2 years in prison. If they both lie, prisoner A will have 5 years, whereas prisoner B will have 10 years. If prisoner A decides to lie and prisoner B decides to confess, they will have 20 and 25 years respectively. And finally, if prisoner A confesses, whereas prisoner B lies, then prisoner A will have 2.5, whereas prisoner B will have 5.5 years. Now let's explore whether there is a dominant strategy. Firstly, for prisoner A. Now let's see, if prisoner B decides to confess, the prisoner A can either have 2 years in prison or 20 years in prison. And obviously, prisoner A would want to minimize this number, which is why it would go with confessing, or 2 years. However, if prisoner B decides to lie, then prisoner A can either have 2.5 or 5 years. And once again, it will decide 2.5 years, as it is a shortened sentence. And therefore, the dominant strategy for prisoner A is to confess. Now let's look at it in the perspective of prisoner B. If prisoner A were to confess, then prisoner B can choose either to confess or lie. But obviously, it would choose to confess because 2 years is less than 5.5. But prisoner A deciding to lie can maybe affect prisoner B's decision. 25 years or 10 years? Well, in this case, prisoner B would decide 10 years over 25 years if prisoner A decides to lie. And therefore, as there is a mix and match of situation, there is no dominant strategy for prisoner B, and only a dominant strategy for prisoner A.